Michelle, and I work here for California State Parks in Oceano. And today we're out at Oso Flaco Lake, which is part of our state park down in Guadalupe. And I'm here to tell you about a really cool bug. It's called the Oso Flaco Flightless Moth. And guess what, you guys? You can only see it here. This is Oso Flaco Lake.
Oso Flaco Lake is a protected area where many different wildlife species live. The trail leads visitors through four dune habitat and straight to the shoreline for a view of the Pacific Ocean.
This moth lives in the sandy coastal four dune habitat, like where I'm sitting right now.
And finally, a sighting of our Oso Flaco flightless moth. But wait, how big are they? Tiny. Look how small it is compared to this penny.
They can be about 5 millimeters in length. A penny is about 19.5 millimeters in length.
Before we learn more about the Oso Flaco flightless moth, can you guys list the things that animals need in order to survive in their habitats?
That's right. They need food, water, air, shelter, like protection from predators and the environment, and space.
Some animals have to change in order to get these things. When an animal changes in order to survive and live in their habitat, it's called adaptation.
There are two types of adaptations, physical and behavioral.
A physical adaptation is when an animal changes some part of its body, such as body movement, body shape, or in the case of this chameleon, body color. A behavioral adaptation is when an animal changes certain types of activities they perform, such as a bear hibernating for shelter during cold winter months.
The Oso Flaco flightless moth has a unique adaptation. It got its name because its wings are reduced in size.
It doesn't fly in the air to travel, but rather runs or hops to get around, sort of like a grasshopper. In fact, some people call it the sand dune grasshopper moth.
Sometimes while hopping, they'll catch a breeze in the air and soar to travel even farther.
What type of adaptation is this?
Is this a physical adaptation or a behavioral adaptation?
That's right, it's a physical adaptation.
It's a physical adaptation because the moth has developed shorter wings in order to survive in their windy environment.
Want to learn one of their behavioral adaptations?
Adults dig small pits into the sand where they crouch low during the windiest parts of the day and at night.
This is a behavioral adaptation because they've changed their sheltering behavior.
This is the moth in its larval state. Do you want to learn something cool?
The larvae are long and thin and live in silk tubes covered in sand. These tubes are attached to the ends of plants growing in its sand dune environment and offer the larva added protection.
I'm going to leave you guys with an assignment. Can you name another animal that uses adaptation to survive in its environment? Send your answers back to me in a video. Thanks for hanging out with me here in the sand at Oso Flaco Lake, learning about the Oso Flaco flightless moth. I hope you guys enjoyed and learned a lot. Until next time.